In this short video, we're going to get familiar with the new screen of Adobe Animate 2020. So let's get started. So what we're gonna cover is the intro screen, which we're looking at. Then we're gonna go on the stage area. We're gonna look at the tools, where the properties are. We're gonna look at the timeline. The timeline is gonna include the layers, frames, and then we're gonna just look at the panels a little bit. So on the 2020 version of Adobe Animate, they added a new intro screen. It's really just a small addition, but anyway, there are basically four things you can do here. You can either open a new file, but then you're gonna have to modify the properties. So I really don't like this way to go about. You can also open one of your recent files that are gonna show up right here in this area. And you can open a file if you know the location. A new file that has never been on your computer in Adobe Animate, so it won't appear here. We can always open it by using this button. And the last thing, and what we're gonna do here to create a new file, is to create new, or you click on more presets. Both of these options are gonna take you to the same place. So I'm gonna go with create new. And that is going to take us to the second screen, which is very similar to the one you had on the previous version. From the new document window, we're going to find different categories, and for like character animation, social game, web, and for each one of those, you know, have different presets. As it's not really that important, you can always change the settings on the details section here. For example, this one preset is telling me that it's 1280 by 720 and the frame rate is 24 frames per second and section script 3. All right, so if I go to the standard 640 or 480, it's gonna tell me the size, but also notice that it changed the frame rate. There's nothing here that prevents me from saying, hey, you know what, 24 frames per second is fine for me. So anyway. All right, so what's important here though is to understand and to make sure that you have the right platform type for this thing. For example, if you're working on animation or movie or something like that, usually you wanna be working on ActionScript 3. If you're producing material for the web, you might wanna be working on HTML5 Canvas. And if you're working for an app, for a desktop, for Android or for iOS, then you're gonna use AIR, which stands for Adobe Integrated Runtime, if I'm correct. There are a couple other platforms. Let's see if we look at advanced. For example, we have WebGL. WebGL runs basically natively on the browser, but still HTML5 Canvas is the way to go, because this is still, the support for WebGL has to be enabled. It's not enabled by default on most browsers, so we don't need to worry about that. So anyway, let's go back to character animation. So, the other thing that you have on this window, before we move on, we have some sample files. These are actually files that show you how to do a lot of stuff on Adobe Animate. So feel free to explore them. You can learn a lot, certainly, from all those. However, the best way to learn is actually by doing your own stuff from scratch, so remember. All right, so I'm going to select the HD 1280 by 720, and I'm going to say create. And that is actually going to create my new document. Now, there's a big chance that when you open your new document, it actually doesn't look exactly like mine, and that is quite okay. So let's start by showing you how to set it in any which way you think you're gonna work better. So here is the workspace sections here, and it has several animators. You know, you can click on each one of them and it's gonna give you different settings depending on what you're doing. Now, what I use usually is classic. However, I already did some customization. So let me remove it. I'm gonna reset it to the original layout. And I do that by clicking that little thing. So this is probably much more what you're looking at on your computer if you're opening Adobe Animate for the first time and you haven't customized it, which, by the way, it will remember your settings. So I feel comfortable using my workspace in a couple of places just because I've been doing it for so long. So I like to set my tools to two columns, and you can do that just by dragging the window. So, and the other thing I like to do is moving the properties on this side. So that way I can click on the tool and I can go here without having to travel from the two different areas on the screen here. All right, so you can choose whatever workspace you want, but if you're gonna be following the tutorials that I'm gonna be doing, then having your setup like this is probably gonna help you to catch up faster with what we're doing. Let's work a little bit right now for a few seconds on the stage here. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take the magnification down to, let's say, 75, so we can see more of this stuff here. Now, the stage has two main sections right here. So this is the stage, yeah, saying it again, but here's the stage. This is everything you put in this area is what is going to show on your product. And then around this, we have what I call the staging area, but Adobe calls it the pasteboard. So anyway, so here in the pasteboard, you can actually put other elements. And I'm gonna use a rectangle right now from this here. Let me change the fill so it's more visible. So maybe orange in the stroke. Let me remove it so I don't have to move things around. And I'm just gonna draw a little rectangle right here. All right, so we have this little rectangle we're gonna use for a couple of examples. So go ahead and put one maybe on your file too. And the first thing is we're gonna run a preview. So I'm gonna do run the preview by doing Control Enter. And he's gonna show me really nothing because the orange rectangle is not on the stage. I'm gonna put it right here. So it's partially on the stage and the other part is outside. And I'm gonna run the preview again. And then you can only see that little section of the square, right? So that's what this is for. There's a couple of things that you can use the stage area. One, for example, is let's imagine that I'm using the alt key. So I can have maybe different squares here for elements that I'm gonna use later, or I can use it to sample colors from my color palette on whatever I'm working. So again, these things won't show up on your final product, so it's a good way to do it. The other thing is to put things that are gonna be coming on the screen when you create an animation and all that. So this pasteboard is actually really useful. Now here, one thing that's gonna be also very helpful for you is to the spacebar. So the spacebar, if you wanna move the stage around, you can press the spacebar and then you can move it. So here it is, for example. Oh, and I had another square here left over from something else. Anyway, now here on the stage, you also have a couple of other different tools. The most important thing is this one, the center stage. So let's say for some reason I have a lot of things on my pasteboard and I don't know where my stage is, I can always click on this one and it will center the stage for me back on the window. So that's really good. Now, I'm gonna talk about this one because this one is kind of confusing and it can cause panic in a lot of people. So let me put this little square here. See, if I press this button here, it's gonna clip the content outside. So the little squares that I have, they're still here, but as long as this is activated, I won't be able to see them. So something like that happens and you don't know what's going on. See, if I move that one around, I can pull it out, but if I don't see it, it's very hard to manipulate it. So if that ever happens to you, don't panic, just click the button again and that will fix it. Now, some of you might be using a tablet, which is really good on Flash. So this thing has a rotation tool that allows you to turn around the tablet, so you can tilt it in any which way when you're drawing. And this is really a good thing here. Again, if you press the center stage, it will actually rotate it back. And this tool, by the way, the hand tool, can also be accessed right here. So you can choose between those three different ones. The time scrub will allow you to see once you start working with the frames, but right now we don't need to worry about it. The next major area we have is the tools. So here, the most important tools on this area is of course the selection tool. So let's go ahead and draw another rectangle here. So I'm gonna click on this rectangle. And also notice on the tools that like any other Adobe product, when you have this little triangle right here on the corner, that means if you actually hold you're gonna get more options for that. So there's different shape tools there. Feel free to experiment with. We'll touch base with them a little bit later. But right now I'm just gonna use it to draw another rectangle right here. All right. And one thing to remember that's really cool is that once you're done doing something on Adobe Animate, you can press the V, as in Victor, key, and then you go back to your selection tool. Let me see. The other cool thing about this is that you can actually customize what shows on your toolbar. For example, here there is this little three dots here. If you click on them, it's going to give you this menu where you can actually drag and drop tools. For example, there's one called the Asset Warp tool that I almost never use, so I'm going to drag it out so I don't want it to appear here. And then there's another here. This is a new tool called the Fluid Brush tool, but right now you see how it shows like a little warning sign. So basically that means that for some reason my system is not able to use it, although it should be it's a GPU brush. It's very similar to the other one, but it has a lot more control. If you have a tablet and a new computer, maybe a good idea to use it. So since I can use it right now, I'm just going to drag it out. And then it's no longer on my menu. Now, for some reason, I want to restore the original settings. I can click right here and press reset, and then it'll put them back. So once I'm done, I can click here, and I can close it. Or I can click here. And I can close it right there. On the top section, we have the main menu. So like that little icon, the house, takes you back to the first screen that you see when you launch any menu. So if you click, you can launch another file if you need to, or open something. We already talked about this screen. Now, if you ever get here by accident, all you have to do is click on Animate. It takes you back to your current file. If you have more than one file, it'll show up right here. By the way, one of the things I didn't mention is like I haven't saved this file, so it shows that with that little asterisk right there. So that's an indicator that I haven't saved my file. See, you have the file, main file here. You can create new files, you can save as, you can do all the different things here. And we're gonna talk more about these menus as we work on some of the tutorials. But feel free to explore. A lot of times also we use commands or shortcuts, things like that. You can actually perform most everything that we do with a shortcut here. Let's see what's important here. Oh, the window. So when we're talking about panels later, this window is going to be very important because every panel that is on Adobe Animate can be activated through here. So this is the window menu. It's important if you ever see you're following a tutorial and you see something that is not on your panels, you can come here and you can actually add it. Next panel that is extremely important is the properties panel. The properties panel is content sensitive. What that means is that it's going to change depending on what you have selected. For example, right now I have selected really just the what do we call this one? I call it the staging area, baseboard. So we have the baseboard selected right now, and I'm not able to open the frame, the object, or anything. But if I click on one of these little guys here, then I can click on the object, and it gives me options for that. But I also can click on the frame now. It gives me options for the frame. I still can access the options for the document without deselecting anything. So this is actually pretty good. It's not giving me options for the tool because I don't have the tool selected, but if I do, then I also get options for my tool. So the property panels is gonna be extremely important. And by the way, here, something that is also good to know. Adobe Animate introduced something called advanced layers. This is going to get on the way once we start using ActionScript. So the way to go about this, the best way I would recommend you do this right now. You click on more settings, make sure you're on the document, and there is a little checkbox that says use advanced layers. I will advise everybody to uncheck this, and it's going to say, are you sure you want to turn advanced layers? I am absolutely sure. And then going even further, I will make it the default. So I'm gonna say okay. And then when I create a new document, that those advanced layers are going to be automatically disabled. The next section on the tour is the timeline. So this is what's probably going to be most strange about Adobe Animate if you are used to Adobe Photoshop or Illustrator. So here, but it's the same concept. So here, let me expand this a little bit right here. And so layers. So layers allow you to keep elements organized in different layers, which is going to be very important for animation. And so here we have the different buttons, so we can create layers like here. And we can also use the trash can here to delete them. We can also organize them. So put them together. So let's say I create these layers and I create a folder. I'm not going to name it. And let's say I'm going to put these two layers here. I'm going to hold the shift key and I'm going to move them to the folder. So they're organized in this folder. This is good because sometimes when you do an animation, it really takes a lot of layers to work. So that way you don't have to be scrolling up and down. I'm going to go ahead and delete that. So yes, and delete the folder and the components. Now here is this one. This one is very important. This one. Show all layers as outlines. So if I ever do that, notice how it's only showing me the outline of my shapes, but not the colors. So that's going to be very useful later. But also in case you accidentally press it and you're wondering, hey, what happened with my colors? Well, that's all. No big deal. Here, you can make them, you can hide the elements also. So that way accidentally you don't select them. And you can also log them if you want to protect your layers from yourself, from accidentally changing something on these layers. You can actually log it. Notice that right now that they're locked, I can actually cannot select any of the elements until I go here and then I unlock them. So that's how the timeline works. Second part on the timeline here is the frames. So the frames is what's going to represent your animation of what happens as you move on your products. So right now we have the, let's look at the document. If we look at the document, it's 24 frames per second, or 24 FPS, 24 frames per second. If that means that for every second of animation that we have, it's going to have 24 frames. So 2 seconds is going to be 48 and et cetera, and you do the math. We're going to mess a little bit more with this once we start doing animations here. Another thing to notice is that when you have content on your frames, you're going to see that full circle right there. And let me create a new layer. When you don't have any content, the circle is going to look empty. This section, we're going to mess with this a little bit more once we start working with animation. The slider right here allows you to increase the size of how you see your frame. So sometimes it's the standard. It's really small. You can always change it here. I almost never touch that. And the last part of this story is going to be the panels here. So here on your side, when you need something, like for example, one panel that I use all the time is the library. So you click on them, and when you click out, right now there's nothing on it. So once you click out, it automatically collapses. The other one that is very useful is the Align panel. And just like any other Adobe product, you can expand the panels if you want to have them visible all the time. I don't like doing it like that because for me it takes too much space, but that's okay if you rather work like this, that's fine. Or if you have two monitors, that's awesome. So I'm going to collapse them like that. And you can also undock the panels. So for example, if I take the library out here, I can undock it, right? And then it's, I can make it a floating panel right here if I want to. So again, doesn't matter how you work on it. Let me dock it back again. And doesn't matter how you do it, it's a matter of preference. Now, what's important is whenever we are using a panel or you're watching a tutorial or something, if you don't see your panel, you can go to Window and just make sure the panel is checked. For example, here, the library, I can actually do that and open it right there. And you can also, for example, remove a panel. So the CC libraries, that's the public libraries that you can have all your assets across different programs and computers. So I'm going to close it and it's gone. If I want to put a panel that doesn't exist, I can always go here, open it, and it'll add it again to your panels bar here. Well, this is it for this episode. Please click subscribe, and on the comment section, let me know what do you think of the video and what other topics would you like me to cover. I hope to see you back for more, and until then, just chill and enjoy life.